Hi there, it's me, Fran Drescher, the founder of the Cancer Schmancer Movement. And today is a very special day because it's my 20-year anniversary of wellness. And to celebrate, we at Cancer Schmancer decided to put on a cabaret fundraiser in support of my organization, Cancer Schmancer. Now, normally around this time of year, we host a fundraiser in New York Harbor as a cabaret dinner cruise. But let's face it, there is a pandemic, so nobody wants to be stuffed on a boat in New York Harbor with hundreds of people. Am I right? I'm right. So we decided let's do a virtual cabaret fundraiser for all of you around the world. And we're presenting it absolutely free with the hopes that you're going to have such a great time and believe so much in what we are doing that you will make a donation. And no donation is too small and obviously not too big. So we are grateful to everything and anything that you feel you're able to give us. So we have unbelievable talent. I mean, it's just so exciting. The people, the talent that has rallied for us on this day in honor of Cancer Schmancer and my anniversary of wellness. And let's not forget, it's Pride Month too. So it's all really exciting. So there's great singers, great comedians, great testimonials, and we're going to have such a good time. Let's kick off this night with one of the greatest Broadway divas. She's a movie star. She's a television star. She's a great, great talent. If you've never seen her perform, you better go because she is one in a mill. Please get ready to hear Miss Patti LuPone.
When a star is born, they possess a gift or two. One of them is this, they have the power to make a wish come true. When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Desires will come to you. If your heart is in your dreams, no request is too extreme. When you wish upon a star, your dreams come true. Fate is kind. She brings to those who love the sweet fulfillment of their secret longing. Like a bolt out of the blue, fate comes in and sees you through. When you wish upon a star, your dreams come true.
Well, I'm especially excited to introduce the cast of Broadway's Ain't Too Proud, The Life and Times of the Temptations. Why? Because I absolutely love that show. And these guys are off the scale talented. We're so happy to have them supporting Cancer Schmancer at this year's cabaret fundraiser. So please give a warm welcome to Matt Manuel with Jelani Remy, Jawan Jackson, James Harkness, and Nick Walker. Ah, love these guys.
I've got sunshine on a cloudy day. When it's cold outside, I got the month of May. talking about my girl, my girl. I've got so much honey, the bees ending me. I got a sweeter song than the birds in the trees. Well, I guess you'd say, what can make me feel this way? My girl,
my girl.
Talking about my girl, my girl. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. I don't need no money, fortune or fame. I've got all the riches, baby, one making claim. Well, I guess you say, what can make me feel this way? My girl,
my girl,
my girl. Talking about my girl, my girl.
Talking about my girl.
I've got sunshine on a cloudy day with my girl. I've even got the month of May with my girl. Hey, talking, talking, talking about my girl, my girl.
Talking about my girl.
My girl.
My girl. Oh, oh, oh,
oh. Happy 20th, baby. I wish you health, happiness, and lots of pasta.
It was cancer, Schmancer, I know. Hi, Fran. It's Rosalind Kind. 20 years and counting. Yes! Everyone, please donate to this marvelous charity. Thank you.
Hello, Fran. My beautiful TV wife and good friend, Stephen Weber, wishing you a happy 20 years of health and 80 more.
Well, I'm very excited about this next singer. She won the Broadway World Cabaret Award for Best Jazz Vocalist. She also toured with Wynton Marsalis. She's a singer, she's a songwriter. She's absolutely amazingly talented, and she brought her bandmates with her. So let me introduce them first because, you know, they volunteered to work and it was really generous of them. I want to make sure I get the names right. So first it's pianist Art Herrera, and then the drummer is Eric Halverson, and then the bassist and arranger is Pat O'Leary. So get ready for a great performance from Miss Gabrielle Stravelli.
Hi, Fran. On behalf of myself and my bandmates, we want to congratulate you on 20 years of cancer-free wellness, and we wish you so many more.
Have you ever seen the rain?
Hi there. Well, I'm really excited to introduce this funny lady. We had the opportunity to meet each other when we were roasting Gloria Allred at the Friars Club. And she is just the sweetest, warmest woman. We're with the same management, so we're practically like mishpacha. And we are just, you know, so supportive of each other. I think she's just so funny and delightful. Please get ready for some big laughs from Judy Gold.
Hey, how's everyone doing tonight? It's great to be here. I'm Judy Gold. I am not singing. I'm going to be doing some stand-up for you. Well, I'm not going to get a reaction, and or I'm not going to hear the reaction, and I'm talking to a computer. So this is pretty much the way it is when I go to the clubs. No reaction. But no, it's great to be here. I am a stand-up comic. I'm actually sitting right now. I'm not. You're only seeing my head because I have gained the COVID-19. Yeah, it's not pretty, but it's an honor. I'm humbled to be a part of Cancer Schmancer. I actually have a new motto out of this pandemic. It's called makeup shmakeup, okay, because I'm done wearing makeup, even though I have to say everyone I know looks their worst or thinks they look their worst because we have nothing, you know, and I realize that we couldn't look worse, and yet we've never had to look at ourselves more. Kind of cruel, don't you think? But, you know, there are good things that have come from this pandemic. My car is getting 4 months to the gallon. Also, I had a couple of friends over for dinner a couple of weeks ago, and we were finished eating dinner, and they got up to leave, and guess what? I didn't have to get up and hug them goodbye. Just sat there on my fat ass. How great is that? How great is that? The other great thing about this pandemic has done wonders for my relationship. Oh my God. No one should be with another person for 24/7. Okay? No one. I don't care who you are. But I've been binge watching, getting to, you know, see a lot of the stuff I never get to see because I'm out at night doing sets to audiences who laugh and I can hear them. And I watched a couple of shows. Oh, I'm on the fence about the Jeffrey Epstein documentary on Netflix because I kind of want to watch it. But, you know, I have to say this whole Jeffrey Epstein thing, you know, why does his name have to be Jeffrey Epstein? It's so upsetting. I'll never forget. I was thinking when this whole thing happened that thank God my mother's not here to witness this because I'll never forget. I'll never forget it in the 70s. Yes, I'm old. But in the 70s, I'm sure you all remember the Son of Sam, right? So he was murdering everyone, serial killer. They can't find the guy. Finally, they get him. And his name ends up being David Berkowitz, right? And my mother... she was beside herself. Oh my God, I can't believe it. David Berkowitz, how could a nice Jewish boy do this? They hate us. They're going to hate us more. Oh my God, this is the worst thing for the Jews. On and on for 2 days. Finally, 2 days, nights later, we're having dinner. She's in a really good mood. I said, Mom, what's with the mood swing? She says, Jeffrey Epstein. She says, David Berkowitz, the Son of Sam, adopted. Come on, you're laughing. And you know what the greatest thing about that joke is? Not that I screwed it up and that I'm not going to go back and re-edit this because that's who I am, but that that joke is, you know, 30 years old. And I got to bring it back.
Well, hi. This gentleman I had the privilege of working with on Broadway in Cinderella. He's also been in great musicals like An American in Paris and Chaplin. The song he's about to sing is sure to put a smile on your face. Please give a warm welcome to Mr. Adam Rogers.
Smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by if you smile. Through your fear and sorrow, smile, and maybe tomorrow You'll see the sun come shining through for you. Light up your face with gladness, hide every trace of sadness, although a tear may be ever so near. That's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you just smile. Keep smiling, everyone.
Hi there, La Franola. Hi, it's me, Charlie. Listen, sweetheart, I wanted to congratulate you on your 20th re-birthday, your 20 years of wellness. Congratulations to you. I'm so proud of everything you've done. You know, there's a Japanese word, kiki, that means crisis. And it's made up of two characters. The first character stands for danger, and the second character stands for opportunity. And I just can't think of anyone who embodies kiki better and more than you do. You turned your crisis, your own personal danger of cancer, into such a blessed opportunity for everyone else. Typical of your generosity and your big heart. But by doing that and turning the lemon of cancer into the lemonade of cancer schmancer, you have, I'm sure, saved countless lives, and everyone owes you a debt of gratitude for that. So thank you. And to anyone watching, if you want to find out more, go to cancerschmancer.org. There's an opportunity there to make a donation on this special night to help early diagnosis. Fran was very quick to realize that early diagnosis can mean the difference between life and death, and that's what Cancer Schmancer is all about. So thank you, my sweetheart, my darling, for doing that. Here's to you. Congratulations on your 20th year of wellness. God bless. See you soon.
Well, it gives me great pleasure to introduce this next gal. You may remember her as Sylvia Fine on the series The Nanny, where she played my mother. But she's a great writer, a great comedian, a wonderful actress, and an especially wonderful friend. So please give a very warm welcome to funny lady Renee Taylor.
Hi, I'm Renee Taylor. I know I look much younger in person, and I'm also much thinner in person because Zoom puts 40 pounds on me. I am always on a diet. You know, anything you eat before the refrigerator door beeps doesn't count. And if you want to lose weight, eat while standing. Eat while walking. But the most weight that you can lose is if you're sleepwalking. Of course, having sex and sleepwalking, or making a sex tape, eating gluten-free pizza could change your whole life. When I gave up gluten, suddenly I could dance. I needed less sleep. I could fly a plane. The minute I gave up gluten, I started getting obscene phone calls from Brad Pitt. I told him, "Hold on, sweetie, I want to get some weed." He told me in a sexy voice I owed him money. I said to him, "You say that to all the girls." And the minute I gave up gluten, my credit score went up. People started thinking that my jewelry was real. And I can now speak Dutch. Heidenswaar. Anybody who sends a donation to Cancer Schmancer in return, I will happily take their gluten off their hands. You send me all your gluten from your pretzels, your donuts, your frozen Corillas, so you won't be tempted by having all that gluten around the house. And I'm sure what happened to me will happen to you. The best thing about being gluten-free, my sex drive has gone through the roof. Oh, that's not how it looks. He just came to deliver some southern fried chicken with gluten-free breadcrumbs.
Sure I did.
I'm going to save this for later.
Well, I am so excited to introduce this next singer because he holds a very special place in my heart. Peter Mark Jacobson is best known as my gay ex-husband, my partner in The Nanny and many other shows like Happily Divorced, which was loosely based off of our life story. And I'm just so proud to call him my best friend. He's a fabulous singer. I've loved listening to him sing since I was 15 years old. He is going to be singing tonight, Time Heals Everything, one of my mother's favorite songs. Please welcome my best friend in life, Peter Mark Jacobson.
Hey guys, welcome to the Cancer Schmancer annual cruise on land. And wow, but what a list of talent this year we have. I mean, it's amazing. All these stars and, well, me. I'm honored to be on the list even, but you know, I slept with the producer. Anyway, so this year I thought I would sing this little ditty and by the amazing Jerry Herman, and hope you enjoy it. Time heals everything, Tuesday, Thursday. Time heals everything, April, August. If I'm patient, the break will mend, and one fine morning, the hurt will end. So let the moments fly, autumn, winter. I'll forget you by next year, some year. Though it's hell that I'm going through, some Tuesday, Thursday, April, August, autumn, winter. Next year, some year, time heals everything. Time heals everything but loving you. The break will mend, and one fine morning the hurt will end. So let the moments fly, autumn, winter. I'll forget you by next year, some year. Oh, it's hell that I'm going through, some Tuesday, Thursday, April, August, autumn, winter, next year, some year. Time heals everything. Time heals everything. But loving you.
Peace.
Well, I'm excited to introduce this next gal. She won the Laurence Olivier Award for her performance in Zorro the Musical in the West End. She's super talented, and she's doing a really funny rendition of a song that's quite apropos for the times. So please give a warm welcome to Leslie Margarita.
Hi, Fran. I just want to say congratulations on 20 years of being cancer-free. What? That's amazing and astounding. Thank you for letting me be a part of this tonight. I wish I could see all of you in person. But again, congrats. 20 years. Come on. Amazing.
A log thrown on the fire. Two profiles met as one. The igniting of desire in the air. But when there's just one profile and yet desire grows, despite the fact there's no one left to care, must romance be abandoned as it's fanning its own flame, waiting to burst full blown? No, there's a special kind of bliss, not engendered with a kiss, surreptitiously indulged in less well known. For when one cannot make love with another, one can still make love alone. Hit it! There's a certain special magic to the touch of your own hand, and that special thrill knowing that you will for sure soon be feeling grand, and that tender swell of rapture you don't have to try to postpone. That's what it's like when you're making love alone. Oh, the sweet, sweet sound of your own breathing as the sky turns pale pink to hot, and that special thrill knowing that you will not catch God only knows what. It's the kind of love that fits hand in glove and bursts like a bud full blown. That's what it's like when you're making love alone. Who can describe the special sweetness of knowing the speed that you're going is right? And is there anything as thrilling as trying to keep 50 shades open to page 24 all night? How reassuring to know when it's finally time to go that you'll still be there when you leave. And as dawn is breaking, you hear yourself making a date for New Year's Eve. It's the kind of love that fits hand in glove, especially if that glove is your own. For the date who you can't see their faces, the one who knows all the best places, who'll never ask what are you thinking as you lie prone and thinking about bags and shoes due to the simple magic of making love, not taking, faking, or mistaking love. The simple magic of making love alone. Film yourself on your phone, click, that's what it's like when you're making love.
Hey, Franny, congratulations on 20 years of wellness. You are an amazing person. We love you. We're in awe of you. Everything you do with legislation, education, cutting-edge medical therapies, also fantastic. You know, I gotta say, we truly believe the world's a better place because of you. We miss you, and we can't wait to see you again soon.
Oh, I'm so excited to introduce this next person. He's so talented. He's absolutely my favorite, Leo Bloom, in the producers on Broadway. And he's a great singer, but he's also one of my TV hubbies. We were just performing together in the NBC series Indebted. I absolutely adore him. Please give a warm welcome to TV star Steven Weber.
Hi there, Franny. It's me, Steven Weber, coming to you from my fabulous library of barely read paperback books and empty candle holders. It seems we stood and talked like this before. We looked at each other in the same way then, but I can't remember where or when. The clothes you're wearing are the clothes you wore. The smile you are smiling then, but I can't remember where or when. Some things that happen for the first time seem to be happening again. And so it seems we have lived before and laughed before and loved before. But who knows where or when? I love you, Fran.
I'm so happy to introduce this next gentleman that I actually had the privilege of meeting when we were on a cabaret dinner cruise on the water in a boat back in the old days before pandemic. Anyway, he's so talented. He's been working since he was 4 years old. He's on Broadway TV. He's toured with Liza Minnelli. Please get ready for a great performance by Mr. Nicholas King.
Hello, Fran, and everybody at the Cancer Schmancer Movement. I am so excited to be a part of the event this year. My name is Nicholas King, and I got the chance to be a guest last year on the Cabaret Cruise for the very first time. Amazing entertainment, great views, wonderful food, and some of the best education, truly. I also managed to snag probably the world's coolest selfie with two of the most iconic New York women of all time. Definitely a huge highlight for me. I've been a very big fan of yours, Fran, for a very long time. You have brought a lot of joy and laughter to so many of us for so many years, and now you're doing such a sensational job at bringing us education and keeping us smart and keeping us in the know with the Cancer Schmancer Movement, and I, for one, thank you very, very much. I'm so glad we've had this time together, just to have a laugh or sing a song. Seems we just get started, and before you know it, comes the time we have to say so long. There's a time you set aside for dreaming, and a time for things you have to do. But the time that I love most is an evening I can spend a moment here with you. When the time comes and I'm feeling lonely, and I'm feeling oh so blue, I just sit back and think of you only, and the happiness still shines through. This will be flower
the darkness of the night. Like the lights of home before me, or an angel watching. Time we have to say so long till I'm with you again.
Stay home, stay healthy, stay safe, and we miss you.
Well, Judy Gold is such a funny lady that we couldn't edit anything that she sent us from her performance, so we decided to break it up into two parts. So sit back and get ready to laugh with Judy Gold, part two.
I've been in a relationship with my partner, Elisa, for 13 years. She's a therapist, which everyone thinks is so great, which, hello? Like, do I need a therapist? I already hate myself. Do I need her telling me why and validating that? You know what I'm saying? But I love her. I love her very much. It's just, it's hard because, you know, when you live with a therapist, nothing you say is benign. Everything has some hidden meaning. I meant to say this. I meant to say that. I really mean that. It's awful, you know? And also, 13 years, it's work. It's work. And the beginning of the relationship, come on, everyone knows, is so great. You know, everything they do is cute and blah, 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 because all you're doing is having sex. But I'm telling you right now, there were a few things that Lisa did in the beginning where I was like, all right, that will eventually get on my nerves. But I don't really care right now because all we do is have sex. And so I said on Cancer Schmancer. Anyway, so so I'm just going to tell you a couple of things she does that I really can't take anymore. Number one, whenever we travel anywhere and the people have accents, after about 90 minutes, she starts talking like them. Like, we were in North Carolina last year, pre-pandemic, no masks, and we're there for about like an hour. I'm like, oh my God, I'm so hungry. So we go to this burger joint and the waiter comes over to the table. He's like, what can I get you? And I said, oh, I'll get a burger and a shake. And Elisa looks up at the waiter and says, how are the sweet potato fries? And I'm like, what is wrong with, why are you talking like that? You're from Westchester. What is going on? Are you okay? So then she tells me she has ILD, imitative linguistic disorder, which I believe because she's a therapist, but she makes up diseases to get out of fights. This is what she does all the time. Like, she'll be so nasty, nitpicking at me all day long, like all day, like just mean and nasty and bitchy. And I'm like, Elisa, what is wrong with you? You're being so nasty today. And she'll be like, oh, I'm sorry. I'm having an episode of SARS. I'm like, SARS, I've heard of that. What is that? Sudden angry response syndrome. I'm like, really? Didn't they used to call that or did they change the name? I said the C word on Cancer Schmancer, yeah. Here's the other thing she does that I really can't stand. But I love her. But so she was sick. Last year she had the flu, not thank God, not COVID. And I was taking care of her. This is pre-COVID. And every time she sneezes, literally every time she sneezes, she says achoo. It's like really loud. It's like achoo, achoo. And I'm like, Elisa, what is that? She's like, I'm sneezing. I'm like, that's not a sneeze. That's a sneeze plus drama you added in for effect. No one says achoo when they sneeze, okay? It's not like, you know, when you pass gas, it comes out fart. You know what I mean? Cough, cough. Yawn. Sigh. Anyway, that was a pause, like, because I was thinking, oh, maybe they're laughing. And then I forgot another part of my joke previously. But this is what happens when you're doing stand-up into the computer. Because, you know, Elisa has this goal. She wants to travel all over Europe with me. And we can't do that now because we can't even leave our houses. And she's like, oh, Judy, we have to travel. We have to see everything. And I was thinking, you know what? I'm not going to travel to Europe with you. I mean, can you imagine? We're in Europe. It's 3 a.m. I wake up in a cold sweat, not knowing where I am. And I hear, Judy, we have to go downstairs with our luggage. All the Jews are meeting in the lobby. Let's go. We have to leave now. That was me waiting for laughter. Anyway, I don't know what to say, except thank you for having me. I've been a fan for years. I love Fran's parents. I love everything you do, Fran. You're so awesome. I love Cancer Schmancer. It's so positive. And listen, the world's changing, but this makes people happy and you make people happy. So thank you. Thank you for having me. Happy Pride to everyone. And I love you. So long!
It gives me great pleasure to introduce this next cabaret diva. She wrote the Nanny theme song, which is, in my opinion, not only the best theme song of the 90s, but of all TV time. She is so talented, not only a great singer, but a great writer, and she's even written songs for the likes of Barbara Streisand. She is incredibly talented, a dear friend, a great supporter of Cancer Schmancer, and a survivor herself. I am so proud to introduce this fabulous woman. Please give a warm welcome to Anne Hampton Calloway.
Hello, everyone. It's Anne Hampton Calloway here, and I'm so thrilled to be a part once again of the annual Cancer Schmancer Cabaret Cruise. Not quite New York Harbor, but it's wonderful to get to sing to you. And it's wonderful to get to honor a friend of mine who I admire greatly. Not only is she one of our most beloved actresses, comedians, but what an incredible health advocate she's been through the years of Cancer Schmancer with her extraordinary team. An everyday hero, Fran Drescher, I love you so much. Keep on fighting the good fight. This is for you with all my heart. People are in need.
Fran. Woohoo!
Happy 20-year anniversary, Fran. Congratulations! I love you.
Congratulations on being cancer-free. 20 whole years, Fran Drescher. What a great day to be. Whoa, yes.
I want to congratulate Fran for 20 years of wellness. I hope you make a donation to Cancer Schmancer because they do a wonderful job of educating us to stay healthy.
Fran Drescher, congratulations on 20 years of Cancer Schmancer. You're the best. I love you so much. I'm so proud of you. I am privileged to know you and get to love you and get to see just how smart you are in real life. You know, you're brilliant, Franny, and I love you, and congratulations, everybody there. Thanks for all you do for that wonderful organization. And Franny, I'll FaceTime you.
Last but not least, it is my great pleasure to introduce to you a gal who is a recording star, a movie star, and now a Broadway star when she revived the role of Dolly in Hello, Dolly! And totally made it her own. She is unbelievably talented. I can even say with great pride that she appeared as a guest star on The Nanny. I consider her my friend. She is also a brilliant philanthropist and a wonderful, wonderful woman. I can't wait for you to hear her sing. Please give a warm welcome to the divine Miss M, Bette Midler.
Hi, Fran. Bette Midler here. Congratulations on being cancer-free for 20 years. It's so fantastic. And congratulations, too, on all the wonderful work you've done for so many people with cancer schmancer. You are one in a million. God bless you.
My daughter Joyce is marrying the doctor, a doctor. So if your kids need shots, just call up my daughter and ask for her husband, the doctor. Gefällt, I may plots. Actually, right now, he's an intern. But soon, he'll be a urologist. So you should all make appointments if it bites when you pish. Every checkup buys a setting and a serving dish. A doctor, oh really, I'm cavelling. It's a Jewish Mother's Day. Because now I can complain about every ache and pain and I never have to pay.
Well, wasn't that wonderful? Thank you so much for tuning in and sharing this celebration with me. It's my 20-year anniversary of wellness, and I couldn't think of a better way to enjoy it than with all of you. And I want to thank all of our friends who so generously offered their talent and time for helping make this event possible. And I don't want to forget the beautiful Hornblower ship, because year after year they generously offer us their boat, and all of the food and everything is donated. And of course, this year we couldn't do it, but we'll see you again in 2021 and have another spectacular cruise in New York Harbor. For now, I wish you all good health and long life, the two best gifts of all. And please, go to cancerschmancer.org more regularly, learn what we're about, and start changing your life. Learn how to be better to your immune system, because if you take care of your immune system will take care of you. So make a donation if you had a good time. There's nothing too small or too large that we won't be in complete gratitude for. We love you and we wish you well. Think peace and be happy. Bye.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
I just want to take a moment to say that I think that we need to recognize what else is going on in this world. So I want to say that it's very important that we all stand along our brothers and sisters from Black Lives Matter. Racism must be stopped, and it must be stopped at once. It cannot be tolerated. It's beneath us all. And it is Pride Month, so I want to recognize the LGBTQ community, and I want to say how great it is that the Supreme Court ruled in favor of gay and transgender rights with Section 7. So bravo for that. And this is a time of disruption. It's a time of galvanizing. It's a time of change and revolution. And I'm right there with you all, because we cannot allow any group to be oppressed or marginalized, and I will go to the mat every day to fight that. So my prayers are for everyone, and may this time blossom into something more beautiful and more tolerant. Love is love.
What a wonderful